Hello and welcome to all in this our YouTube channel. Now students, in continuation with the last lecture, in our today's lecture we are going to discuss electrochemical cells. Now students, an electrochemical cell which consists of two metal plates or carbon rods. These electronic conductors are dipped into an electrolytic or ionic conductor. So such a type of cells we are calling it as electrochemical cells. Now students, these are made of graphite material. So students, these plates or these metal plates, or we can say the carbon graphite rods, which we are using for the conduction in the electrochemical cell. Now students, after that we are going to discuss the next part, which is nothing but the electrochemical reactions. Now students, one of the question they have asked in your textbook, what is the reaction involving transfer of electrons from one chemical species to another called? Means electron transfer is taking place in which form, that you have to know first. Means the reactions in nature, some reactions are there, through that reactions electron transfer will occur. Now which type of reactions are there, and if we able to give some examples of it, that question or such a question they have asked in your textbook. Now students, such reactions are called as a redox reactions. Redox, this name which has two meanings, reduction as well as oxidation. Means in these reactions either loss of electron will take place or gain of electron will take place. Now in which case loss of electron will take place and gain of electron takes place, that we are going to discuss in details in this type of reactions. That reactions we are calling it as a electrochemical reactions. Now students, the chemical reactions occurring in electrochemical cells involves transfer of electrons from one species to the other. It is a redox reaction. We learnt in our 11th standard in chapter 6. Now students, in that chapter, in that separate chapter redox reactions, we have learned some basic concepts which are related with the redox reactions, and we have also seen some examples of it. Means which reaction is calling it as a reduction reaction, which type of reaction is calling it as oxidation reactions. All these concepts we have learned in our that redox reaction chapter. Now students, in continuation with that, electrochemical reactions are made of oxidation and reduction half reactions. The oxidation half reactions occurs at one electrode and reduction half reactions occur at another electrode. The net cell reaction is sum of these half reactions that we are going to see by considering an diagram also. Before going to that students, we are going to learn definitions of electrodes. Electrodes are the surfaces on which oxidation and reduction half reactions takes place. Electrodes may or may not participate in the reactions. Now students, the electrodes which do not take part in reactions are inert electrodes. So the role of electrodes is nothing but in a specific reactions, transfer of electrons which is takes place with the help of these electrodes. Now during that transfer, which electrode gains electron or which electrode lose electrons, that in detail we are going to see by considering the following two definitions. In that, the first one is cathode. Now students, what is meant by cathode electrode and what is meant by anode electrode? In details we are going to look at here. It is an electrode. For cathode I am going to discuss, it is an electrode at which the reduction takes place. At this electrode, the species undergoing reduction gains electrons. So if we consider for cathode, at cathode always reduction reaction will take place, and reduction is nothing but the species which undergoes reduction which gains electrons. Now students, opposite to this, one another electrode is present, which is we are calling it as a anode. Anode, it is an electrode at which oxidation takes place. At this electrode, the species undergoing oxidation loses electrons. Students, anode plays an opposite role to that of cathode. This is also an electrode. At this electrode, oxidation process will take place, and oxidation is nothing but losing of electrons. So these are the two types of electrodes which we have discussed here. One of the trick I am going to give to all students, how to remember at which electrode which process is taking place. You have to remember as a anodic oxidation and cathodic reduction. This sentence you have to keep in mind at every time, and if you keep this point in your mind, you will not be get confused for the remembrance of these two concepts, anodic oxidation and cathodic reduction. This sentence you have to keep in mind. Now this is all about the electrodes, that is cathode and anode. Now students, in our next point we are going to discuss the types of electrochemical cells. There are two types of electrochemical cells. In that, the first one is electrolytic cell. Students, in this type a non-spontaneous reactions are taking place, and that we are calling it as a or known as a electrolysis, which is forced to occur by passing a direct current from an external source into the solution. In such a cells, electrical energy is converted into chemical energy. So this is the important thing that you have to keep in mind, which energy is converting into which energy. Electrical energy is converted into chemical energy. Students, you have to underline this sentence. The anode of electrolytic cell is positive and cathode is negative. This is also very important. So students, before going to know the electrolytic cell, we should know about where the requirement of such a type of cell is we are going to require. So according to the requirement, we are using a type of cells. Electrolytic cells is used at that place where we need a chemical energy. Means it plays an important role for the conversion of electrical energy into chemical energy. Now where we require the chemical energy, this is very important. Now students, in our day-to-day life, we are going to come across some different examples such as electroplating, or we can say coating of different metals for the protection of corrosion. So these are the examples where we need chemical energy. Means, students, with the help of electrical energy, we are converting that electrical energy into corresponding chemical energy. This is an important role of the electrolytic cells. So whenever we are required to electroplate one of the material, suppose if you want to electroplate an iron rod with the copper metal, with the silver metal, or different kind of metals, we need the help of electrolytic cell. And in that case, students, the anode in that case will be positive and cathode will be negative. So this is a important thing that you have to keep in mind. Now, students, the another type of cell we are going to look in details is nothing but the galvanic or voltaic cell. Now, students, in galvanic or voltaic cell, a spontaneous chemical reactions produces electricity. Students, we have stated an electrolytic cell. In that case, we have said that non-spontaneous reactions are taking place. And here, spontaneous chemical reaction takes place. What is the difference between these two? Spontaneous means the continuous chemical reactions by which they produce electricity, and non-spontaneous in the sense after some time the cell get automatically stopped. This is the difference between both of these two cells. So this is the important thing that you should know about these two cells. Now, students, after that, in these cells, means in galvanic cells, chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. What does it means? Which is opposite to that of electrolytic cells. Now, students, in this case, for the production of electrical energy, we are making some arrangements, means we are constructing some types of cells. That cells we are calling it as a galvanic or voltaic cells. Now, students, you should remember this point. The anode in the galvanic cell is always negative and cathode is positive. This is a very important thing for the identification of whether it is galvanic cell or electrolytic cell. So these are the two types of cells. Now, whenever we are going to look at the examples of galvanic cells, there are number of examples which we are going to observe in our daily life. Some of the examples are nothing but the cell which we are using in watch, or different kinds of button cells, or the batteries which we are using in cars, two-wheelers, motors, etc., etc., or different kinds of toys which run on the different kinds of batteries, cells, etc. In batteries, you already seen, if you break the battery, you will get a different kinds of materials inside the battery, which a carbon rod at the center you will get, and after that you will notice some black colored powder inside it. So these are the chemical materials which are filled in that cell, and with the help of that chemical material, what you are going to take is nothing but the electrical energy. So this is the reason behind that, by which we are going to produce the electrical energy with the help of chemical material. Means here chemical energy is converted into corresponding electrical energy. So this is all about the types of cells in this our today's lecture. In our next lecture, students, we are going to discuss the electrolytic cell in detail with some examples. So this is all about in our today's lecture. Thank you. Thank you very much.